imagine a state of death, questioning if I cannot be here in the sound, whether my expression, my output, my presence will ultimately be ineffective and lost in this audible world. To me, silence is a precious privilege that can help me withdraw from the terror of everyday noise. The noise of thoughts and mundane activities. The noise of questions and answers. The noise of false and truth. The noise of cause and effect. There has always been a sense of loudness in my identity. A loudness that cannot be concealed or disguised. A loudness that cannot be prepared or masked. I receive sound too literally, completely, utterly, without any filter. I have no choice but to swallow the fullness of sound. So I made myself deaf, grew ears on my limbs, told stories in my skin. I grow ears everywhere and anywhere, just to learn how to listen and forget how to listen. I try to listen to the smell of my leftover perfume, a lingering scent of vetiver, cedar, pink pepper, sandalwood, and frankincense. I listen to the smell of the moldy corners of the ceiling. I heard that the room was filled with a twisted and grotesque greenness and warmth. The smell swirls and tangles like the texture of an old tree. The deafening shade of light, stoning like drumbeats, strolling towards a crescendo that cannot be reached. I listen to the distances between objects, hearing the space through depth, time, leaves, and facade. I made myself there to listen to the serene, the chaos, the cluster, and the complexity of the world. To listen to a grain of rice, a car horn, door slamming, bird tweeting, and goodwill. To listen to the silence in the dark, the loudness of day. So when the rain falls, we can listen to the skyline. To listen to those fleeting, unbound, ghostly fractions in the event of life. Listen to the everlasting, the evergreen, and the ever-new.
Thank you. I'm